Bob, we've had the DT-1 and the DM-1 out for a number of years, and now you've come out with the -2 model. So now we have a DT-2 and a DM-2. What's the reason for the new models?
Right, so when we started with the DT-1, we wanted a really fast machine. We wanted them narrow so we could pack them in, not need to get around on the sides.
Right.
And the DT-1 was very successful, so we, people asked for a 40 taper version. That was the DM-1. And really, once we came out with the DM-1, people wanted room for more parts, bigger parts, and put a rotary table on one end. So we gave it 8 inches more travel, come up with the DT-2 and DM-2.
Okay, but it does look quite a bit different. I mean, when I walk up to it, the first thing I see is the tool holder, the shelf. These are things I'm used to seeing on the VMCs.
Right, we've added them to all of the DT line now. It's pretty recent, just this year.
And you mentioned the bigger door. What's nice is on this machine, we've got our HA2TS, which is a dual 5C indexer with pneumatic tailstocks. You couldn't have got this in the DT1 or the DM1.
Right, going from 20 to 28 inches is quite a bit.
Yeah,
quite a bit.
Makes a big difference. So all the great features of the DT and the DM1 are still on here.
Right.
So we've got the super fast tool change, we've got the 2400 inch per minute rapid.
Yeah, we were able to keep the same accelerations and speeds even though we have more mass to move.
And 15,000 RPM spindle.
Right.
And that's whether it's a DT or a DM, we've got 15,000 RPM, correct?
Right.
Great. So the demo we have here today is the HA2TS rotary. And in this case, we're cutting steel, but we're not doing a heavy, aggressive cutting demo. We want to show the speed of the machine.
Sure.
So you'll see 15,000 RPM on the spindle. You'll see a lot of the fast rapids. So let's run it. Nice about this program is we're using every bit of travel, and you can see how close the tool's getting to the indexers.
That's impressive. And it's peeling the steel right off too.
It is, and even though we're not doing heavy cutting on this particular demo, what's nice is you guys have still left in that high 15 horsepower spindle assembly, so it's capable of taking some big cuts.
Even cutting dry, it really sounds good.
It does. You know, no matter how many times I watch one of these machines, I'm always impressed by the speed of that tool change.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but it's not even working hard.
Yeah, if you look at the spindle load,
it's 3%,
yep.
20%.
Yeah, this machine is capable of a lot more in terms of horsepower.
Yeah, I love the rapid.
One thing about this machine, now that you've got the stretched version, the DT2 and the DM2, it's almost the size of a BF2 inside.
Right.
But
yeah, less Z travel, but almost the same X and Y.
That's right. And what's nice about this machine is its compact footprint. And if you compare it directly to a BF2, you can make a part, take the same program from the BF2, put it in here, you're going to make this part almost 33% faster. But I can imagine if you've got a part with a bunch of holes, how quick this machine is going to be.
Well, that's why we started off calling it a drill and tap. All those rapids really cuts a lot of time out.
And on this machine, you can tap at 5,000 RPM.
Right.
That makes a big difference as well if you're tapping a bunch of holes.
Yeah, it's fun to watch.
And it's done. Cool. Let's check out the DT2, because I see we're building one right over here.
Okay.
So here's the DT2, and from the outside, it looks exactly the same. So the only difference is a 30 taper spindle where the DM2 is a 40 taper and the DT has 20 tools instead of 18.
Right, exactly. Those are the differences. Hard to tell them apart.
It really is.
Didn't see the little tool holders.
Yeah, if you didn't see the decal in the small tool holders, you wouldn't know them apart. So, DT-2 and DM-2, two new machines to add to the family.
Yep, we're always working on something new, Bryan.
Great. I appreciate your time today, Bob.
Anytime.
Thanks.